farmers know that even few hours of frost can cost them a year's worth of work and a lot of money. In some extreme cases, frost can lead to so much damage that replanting is simply unavoidable. Methods for controlling frost include wind machines, hot air systems, and propane burners. But by far, the best frost protection comes from targeted overhead sprinkler systems. This method also offers the lowest investment cost per hectare and the lowest energy consumption, making it the leading choice of farmers globally. So, how does watering above the canopy actually protect trees from frost? This is how it works. Since the temperature of the water being sprayed is higher than the temperature of the air and the plant, we actually transfer heat to the surrounding air and to the plant, which improves microclimate near the trees. The water that lands on the plant creates a thin layer of ice. In the water freezing process, there is a release of latent heat. For each 1 gram of water, 80 calories of energy are released. Last is the ice barrier. This thin layer of ice is constantly formed, melted, and reformed, never reaches temperatures as low as the air. It creates a barrier between surrounding cold air and the plant's tissues, keeping it always few degrees above the dangerous freezing point. So we have microclimate, latent heat, and ice barrier, all keeping your crop safe from harm. Here are a few tips to help you choose a sprinkler system for frost protection that does the job you need. Frost impacts the whole plot simultaneously, so you need to make sure you have chosen a system that can work effectively across the entire area. You cannot afford to rely on a system that works in shifts. Find the plots that are exposed to the frost and make sure that you have enough water capacity to operate the whole covered area at the same time. The advantage of targeted system compared to a full coverage one is in the ability to apply water only on the crop you want to protect. If you need to protect only 50% of the surface, the system dimensions and the cost can be reduced significantly. The challenge is to design a system with good coverage, the minimum amount of emitters, and the lowest possible flow that still provides good protection.